I'm like, I feel okay, kind of shocked, but it's fine. So I took on the train, and all the people are just looking at me. It's like, so it's like, I don't know, but it's terrible. And eventually I called my husband. I said, you know, I had this accident. He picked me up from the train station, and he called my neighbor to help driving the car home. And they were looking at me like, wow, what happened, right? So then I had to go to the doctor's office to check. So the next day, I spent the whole day with the doctor, check everywhere, because we were so worried if Mark was doing okay. But eventually, he was fine. I was like, okay. So my lesson was, first, you don't think like you wouldn't fall down inside, because I was very careful outside. But then I thought everything is okay when I eventually fell down inside. So my lesson was like, be careful everywhere for that. And then I'm like totally off.
Are you sure? Okay, good. Name me two things that you think were good.
Posture.
Okay.
And I don't know. You tell me.
Voice production is good?
Yeah.
Okay. Two things that you know need to work on.
Content.
Yes.
And the other thing is, I don't know.
You leave off a lot of ending consonants.
Okay.
And things just start to sound like open vowels.
Okay.
Yeah. So do you want to try it again?
Sure.
And just make it up as you go. That's fine. Okay.
Okay.
Try it again.
Let me go.
Yes, please do.
I think what started?
Okay.
Hi, everyone.
Hi.
So, how does this sound to you? Hi, everyone. Hi, everyone. Or how does this sound? Hi, everyone.
Oh.
Hi, everyone.
Hi, everyone.
Hi, everyone. So the emphasis is on hi. The other flow sounds stilted. It sounds foreign.
Okay.
Hi, everyone. Hi, everyone. Why? Hi, everyone.
Hi.
Hi, everyone.
Yes.
Oh,
or
okay.
Hi, everyone.
Hi, everyone.
Hi, everyone. Slur them together. Hi, everyone.
Hi, everyone.
Yeah, you're stopping for the E on every.
Oh.
I'm not. Hi, everyone.
Hi, everyone.
Hi, everyone. Why?
Okay.
How about hi, everyone.
Hi, everyone.
Hi, every.
Hi, everyone.
No, not hi, ev. Hi, every.
Hi, every.
Hi, every.
Hi, everyone.
Almost.
Hi, everyone.
Hi, every.
Hi, every.
So I'm not going hi, every. I'm going hi, every. I'm slurring them together.
Hi, everyone.
Yes, so then hi, everyone.
Hi, everyone.
Do you hear the difference? I'm going to do it two ways. Hi, everyone. Or, hi, everyone. There is no reason to stop the E on every. It's okay, but if you want to be natural, hi, everyone.
Hi, everyone.
Well, you're not going to do it.
Okay.
Keep going.
I'll try.
That's right. Keep going.
Have you ever carried a 20-pound
carry,
backpack?
What's carry?
Carried.
Thank you. Have you ever?
Have you ever carried a 20-pound
carried.
Backpack? Carried.
So remember what I said? If I fix something, overdo it. Have you ever carried?
Have you ever carried a 20-pound backpack?
Yes.
Yes.
You have. As a software engineer, I always carry a backpack with me, put everything in it. It almost like 20 pounds. Have you ever carried two Backpacks. Have you ever carried two backpacks?
Much better. No, I have not.
No.
Nobody, right? But I have.
Go. You doing good?
When I was pregnant with my younger son Mark, 11 years ago. When I was pregnant with my younger son Mark, 11 years ago, I was like carrying two 20 pounds backpacks.
Okay, so here's a rule. I haven't made many rules, but here's one. You don't get to use the word like the way your teenagers do.
Yeah, you mentioned that. Yeah.
Absolutely forbidden, especially in a Toastmasters speech, especially in a presentation for your company or your boss or the people that work beneath you. Min had a really hard time with that. She goes, oh, Ron, everybody does it. I go, that doesn't make it right. If you want to be more sophisticated and more mature, you can't talk like a teenager. Go on. I have. Start there.
When I was pregnant with my younger son Mark, 11 years ago, I was carrying two 20 pounds backpack.
Okay, backpack. Pounds? Two 20 pounds backpack?
20 pounds.
Yeah, why did you,
I was wondering why will you...
Yeah, pound. Two 20 pound backpacks.
Two 20 pound backpacks.
Much better, backpacks.
I
She's such a giggle britches. Were you like that when your husband dated you? Oh, I'll go out with you. I love you. Oh, Mark, you're so cute. You're such a giggler. I like that. Yeah, don't ever lose that. That's really good.
Okay.
So now that you're slowing down and articulating, I'm really liking this because you have a really good voice.
Okay.
I was carrying two, here's all these T's. I was carrying two 20-pound backpacks.
I was carrying two 20-pound backpacks.
Yes! Yes! Go! Stop laughing! Think of dead people. Think that Santa's not coming to your house because you've been a very bad girl. Do they have Santa in China?
No.
No. Well, there's no...
He's Swedish.
He's not Swedish.
Santa's Swedish.
No, St. Nicholas? He wasn't Swedish. The origin of St. Nicholas is not Swedish. Anyway, so what in China, what do they celebrate? The New Year, right?
New Year, Chinese New Year.
Yeah. So do you celebrate the world that the you know, do you guys have Christmas trees and that sort of thing in China?
No,
nothing.
No.
Oh.
Decorations.
No decorations?
We have right now. Here.
What?
Latin?
We have that right now.
We have that right now.
We have that right now.
Thank you. I know you don't want to do it, but it changes you so much. Yeah. Go on. After two 20-pound backpacks, what's next?
I don't know.
Give me two more sentences.
At that time, I went to downtown office every day for work.
I went to downtown office. What's wrong with that sentence?
I went to the downtown office.
The little word was missing, right? All right. No cheating. You got to say all the little words. I went to the downtown office.
I went to the downtown office every day.
This is a good example to bring up. That when there's a word that ends in a T and the word that begins with a T, you don't have to say them both. So I went to, instead of I went to. You can do both if you want, but it's permissible to do I went to, and she did that. It was good. I went to
the downtown office every day.
The downtown office.
The downtown office.
The.
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 The downtown office every day.
You do want to sound normal, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so the
downtown office.
Every day.
Every day. One day, it snowed very heavily.
Heavily. Good. Go ahead.
One day it snowed very heavily. Very heavily.
Don't look at me, I'm
okay. I walked from my office to the Union Station for 20 minutes.
You made a tremendous amount of improvement.
Okay.
So what are two take homes from this time together?
One is
articulating. Yes, remember how we talked about last week about the letter U has a gazillion pronunciations, right? In this spot, it actually sounds the way you say it in the alphabet. So it's U-V-W.
Articulating.
There you go. Okay. Articulation. Okay, what else?
The other one is don't skip the D, T at the end.
Right. Ends of words. Very good. Really good job. Yeah, except for the giggling.
That's part of it.
Go to the restroom
first.
Go ahead, go. You guys want a break?
No.
No,
no
break. You take 5 minutes?
No time for a break. Keep going.
So we have 1, 2, 3.
Oh, when you are counting, just don't.
Yeah, we have 4. We're good. We'll go over 8. It's fine. Or just be so good that I don't have to have anything to say. Make the teacher not talk. Do you want to go?
No, I just...
Why are you standing up?
Break.
The watch reminded me.
Oh, got it.
Oh.
This was yours, right?
Oh, yeah. Thank you.
You're welcome. My pleasure. Okay, good.
Oh. You stop this.